So there it is, one of the very few tech products of the past year that didn't leak. So this is your first public look at the Tesla Model Y. So my first reaction to seeing it first rolled up on stage was, yep, looks about right. Looks like a bigger Model 3, a little taller, but you know, from this front angle on stage, very familiar, very similar. And the specs, of course, are similar too. So it's gonna be 230 miles with standard, up to 300 mile range with the long range version. And then you can see the acceleration numbers, pretty modest if you ask me, if you're not getting the performance version. But of course the performance one is zippy at 3.5 seconds, 0 to 60. And the price range and release dates are all here. It's gonna start at $39,000, but similar to Model 3, they're not gonna be making that base model cheapest version right off the bat. They're gonna make the higher end, more margin filling models starting in fall 2020, then the base model at $39,000 will come by 2021. Also, you may have noticed when they got that car up on stage, seven people got out of it. So Tesla is saying Model Y is a seven-seater with three rows of seats. That is something I had to see in person because that's it doesn't look that much bigger than Model 3. But that's exactly what I did. So when Elon was done on stage, we got to go outside and see it in person a bit more for ourselves, go for a test ride, and take a closer look. Now seeing it outside and driving on a different light, basically the more angles I see it from, the more I see it as basically a hybrid in design between the Model X and the Model 3. It's like the two of them had a baby or something. And really it's mostly Model 3 since it's sharing parts with it, but with a few differences. So one, it's bigger than Model 3. That's the obvious one. Two, there's an all-glass panoramic roof now, which looked really cool and seamless, but was literally impossible to get footage of tonight. Three, the ride height is a little higher, and that's on purpose. So you sit a little higher in the same seats in this crossover than you would in the Model 3. Four, I think the front trunk should be a bit deeper as well. That is me speculating. They didn't let anyone open the front trunk or rear trunk, but it looks like that should be the case. And five, speaking of trunks, the hatchback. So it is now an automatic lifting rear lift gate. That is great for cargo. I love the Model S hatchback. I've had all four tires in the back of my car the other day, so I'm happy to see that. That's gonna be great for space. And then number six, with all that extra space, there is a third row option now, like we saw. Seeing it in person, it looks extremely cramped, and my gut reaction is I don't recommend it. If you need three rows worth of people on the regular, get a bigger car, like a Model X type of size, because if you do put people on the third row, yeah, you better hope they're either smaller or much younger, because the legroom and headroom seem to be both extremely limited. Model X has more space, of course. And number seven, something I found really interesting. So if you look at the parts where there is normally chrome on the Model 3, so the door handles, the window trim, the mirror pieces where it's normally really shiny, all of these pieces on the Model Y, as you can see, are a sort of a satin matte black color. And it turns out that's the way it's gonna be. There are no shiny chrome pieces on this car. It's like a factory chrome delete, so you don't have to get your car wrapped to get rid of the chrome anymore. So I think that's pretty sweet. Not a lot of people notice that. And that's mainly it. So, I mean, you know, I got my 30-second test drive like everyone else who waited. It was pitch black. The footage was almost useless, but hey, I got to ride in it. And one of the angles that you actually don't get to see as much in a lot of the videos you're gonna start to see is the back of the car, like the butt of it. To me, it kind of looks like a Model 3 with the lights, but then with the tall shape of the Model X, but no spoiler. So again, very hybrid-like. And the interior, as far as steering wheel and display and the seats and everything, is exactly the same as the Model 3. So basically, if you like the Model 3's looks, you'll like this. If you didn't like the Model 3's looks, then this is going to change your mind or anything. But that's about it. I mean, all the time I got to spend with Model Y was pretty brief. Hopefully we get to spend more time with it soon. Maybe we can do an autofocus episode in the daylight sometime. That would be sick. Also, bonus, I got to spend a hot minute with the 2020 Roadster. First time I've ever seen the car in person, actually, and sweet baby Jesus, that car looks incredible. I want it to exist so bad right now. So many things about it, like the carbon fiber in the wheels, the rear diffuser, the screens on the inside, the seats, the color, the aero, the bodywork, everything. So hot. I really hope it's on time. That car is sick. Anyway, that's been it, guys. Hope you enjoyed your first look at Model Y, the affordable, slightly larger Model 3 with a third row option and a hatchback liftgate. I really do think it will sell more than the Model 3 because of the utility, but only time will tell. So stay tuned for more videos. Either way, thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace. red and black?
Okay. Yes.
Oh, so many memes.